Welcome to the Urban Pitch Podcast, the beautiful game of life. Today we have two good-looking, awesome, European, studly freestylers in the house. PWG, Philip, and VLO, Viktor, from Sweden. Welcome.
What's up?
Thanks for having us here.
Great. You guys are happy to be in L.A.?
Yeah, it's better than Sweden at this time of year, at least.
Way better than Sweden.
Is it like really cold out there right now, or what?
It's really cold.
Okay.
So what, 8 degrees?
Celsius. 8 degrees. Celsius, okay.
If it's a good day, yeah.
We go by Fahrenheit, so we have no idea what that is. But anyways.
Almost, you know, freezing point. So. Okay.
How long have you guys been friends, and how do you guys know each other?
I mean, first time I met you, I think it was... What was that? The Gothenburg Red Bull Street Cell qualifiers in 2009,
I think.
I was touring, and then there was a qualification, Red Bull Street Cell national qualification for the national finals.
Yeah.
And there, I couldn't go to Malmo, where my closest qualification. So I went to Gothenburg, where he was. And he was just a little kid. He was like, what, 12?
12 right. years old.
So you're, okay, so let's set the guidelines, right? So you're 20 and you're 25.
Yeah.
Right? And so you guys are still young. You guys are professional freestylers. So what's the situation then? Are you guys students? Are you in college and you're doing this on the side part-time? What is it? What's the situation?
100% freestyle.
100% freestyler, making money off it, and this is your full-on gig, right?
Yeah, I also do like small part-time gigs at Unisport, which is like a retail company that sells football products.
For sure.
So
we know what Unisport is. We'll go into that. You got money coming in from a corporate company.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah. All right. And then?
Yeah, 100% freestyle on summer.
During the summer only?
During winter, there's not a lot of gigs.
Okay.
So sometimes you have to work with something.
Right.
Something else during winter.
Okay, but you're not going to school, or so you you focus on freestyle.
I focus on freestyle, and that's my goal. Yeah,
and that's how you make your money. And then during the times when it's cold and it's freezing in Sweden, you got to do whatever you got to do. Right.
Then you just train.
Right.
And yeah.
Okay.
Go with flow.
Great. Okay. So then you mentioned Unisport, right? So Unisport is a large retailer, right? Based in where?
Copenhagen, Denmark.
Okay, Denmark. Okay. And so then you are what's your role there?
Basically, I'm just a skill guy.
Okay.
So we are three web TV hosts for the YouTube channel. There's one boot nerd, Jay Mike. Mm-hmm. We got Joltter, who is the fancy dude.
Yeah. We know Joltter. Yeah. Joltter came to our facility.
Really?
Yeah, last year. He filmed there. We said hi and all that. Yeah.
That's sweet. Yeah, he's a good guy.
Yeah.
But he's injured right now, so we need a skiller. So that's me, basically. So I just put on new boots, use a new ball, a new gear, and do tricks.
Okay. So is there a little bit of competition between you and Joltter? Because you guys are both in the same kind of...
You mean by popularity-wise?
More like you guys are both like young, good-looking guys, and you kind of have the same skill sets. You're more of a freestyler, and he does some freestyle, but he's more of a techers kind of guy, right? So I guess there's a little bit of differentiation,
Yeah, he's got the
right?
free kicks, and he's doing lifestyle.
Anybody can do lifestyle, so you can just take over that from Joltter, right?
Look at my shoes, though.
Yeah. Okay.
No, there's no... competition.
Yeah. There's three guys from Unisport representing the company.
Exactly.
Okay.
So, but on the Monday meetings, sometimes we talk about Instagram followers and stuff. So,
There's a little bit of competition there, right?
Yeah.
He's got like, on the Instagram side, you guys are rough around the same. He's got what, 100,000 something? You got over 100,000 on Instagram.
Yeah, 119 right now.
What does he have? We can look it up.
I don't even
know. You looked it up yesterday. Yeah.
No, I
in
didn't.
The
I
same vicinity,
didn't.
Though.
Okay. Somewhere, above 100, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So in terms of that, you guys kind of a little bit of friendly competition at least, right?
Yeah, friendly.
Okay. Got it. Okay. So then you guys have been in LA for how long now?
For 2 weeks now.
2 weeks?
2 weeks, yeah.
And just hanging out with freestylers and all that, but it's just for fun only?
Just for fun.
Just chilling and training.
Vacation,
basically
chilling,
nothing else.
Chilling and training or chilling and drinking? What was that?
Training.
Oh, training.
Drinking and training?
Got it.
What?
Training. Yeah, hanging out, just having fun.
Yeah,
we try to train as much as we can every day.
Yeah,
just explore
for sure
for the time that we have left over after training. And usually, since the LA traffic is not optimal.
It's brutal. Yeah, it's brutal.
So
it sucks. We're not sensitive here. It sucks. Yeah, it sucks.
So it's not the best situation to try to do something after training.
Yeah.
So we don't have that much time.
Okay.
Yeah.
But this was you guys planned it out just to come to LA to have fun, basically.
Yeah, we have no.
No agenda.
No plans.
Okay.
I never been here before, so really wanted to go here.
Okay, awesome. So what were so why were you guys so busy? Where like, because we tried to hit you up like a week ago to do the podcast, and you're like, nah, we couldn't do it. So we're like, well, what's up with that then?
We don't like making plans for our vacation. So, okay, so we're like, if something came up and we had like
a push us aside until the day before the
we're leaving tomorrow.
Like, we're leaving tomorrow. We got 6 hours off. We'll squeeze you in. Is that what the situation is?
Kind of. Yeah. The last resort.
Oh wow. Hey, we don't mind. Yeah, we're desperate.
We're here at least.
We appreciate the love, though, right? The last minute love. All right. So then while you guys are here, okay, let's talk about a little bit about Sweden, okay? Like, when most people think of, like, soccer or football and freestyle, whatever, in Sweden, they think of, like, Zlatan. Are you guys also, like, fans of the sport and the game outside of freestyle? Or are you guys just more of the, you know... The freestyle.
I'm definitely a fan of football.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, me too. I don't watch football every week, mm-hmm. but you know, whenever my team's playing and I'm around, I'll try to go see them play.
Okay. Because we're missing Champions League right now because of this. You know,
I know. What's the score?
I don't know.
It's Juventus Barcelona. It was 2-0.
Juventus Barcelona. Yeah. We're missing the game. Come on, dude. We're missing it for you guys, you know?
Well, thank you.
Okay.
And we're missing it for you guys.
All right. But okay, so you're from Malmö?
I live in Malmö, yeah.
You live in Malmö, okay. So that's Zlatan's hometown, right? Malmö FF, right?
Malmö FF, yeah. Okay. So I live 5 minutes from where I grew up.
Okay, and have you ever been to the games?
Malmö FF?
Yeah.
Yeah, the last game I was watching was like, I think it was last year or 2 years ago. I don't really go, you know, because it's not my team.
Yeah.
But I got free tickets to Malmö Real Madrid in the Champions League group stage. So that was pretty cool. But I haven't watched much football, like live.
I see.
Since.
Okay. What about you, Viktor?
I'm from Gothenburg.
Okay.
Which is like 3 hours from Malmö.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And do you ever go to games yourself or what?
He's an ultra.
No, you are? I'm not an ultra.
You
are?
I know. You kind of, I can see how you cause problems.
He used to be. Because
games.
Of the biceps?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
No, but I support a team called ÖIS.
Okay. One more time, because nobody got that.
ÖIS.
How do you spell that?
Örgryte.
It's like UHS.
How do you spell it?
O with two dots.
Yeah. Okay. O with two dots.
I. S.
ÖIS.
Yes.
ÖIS. Okay.
Yeah. Got so I support them and I try to go watch their games when I'm home.
Okay. Yeah. So how did you guys get into freestyle then? Because I feel like you guys were, you have a soccer background, but it's not like huge. So how did you guys get into, you know, you start and then tell us how you got into freestyle.
Yeah, I watched a video. This was before YouTube. Mm. You know, that's how old I am. Yeah. I saw a video.
Yeah. 25, by the way. Yeah, 25.
Exactly.
Okay, yeah.
Wow. I saw a video of Ratinho.
Okay.
You know Ratinho?
Ratinho.
He was doing, his video Fair Factor 1, I think. Mm. And me and a friend, we just watched his video over and over and over, and we didn't understand what was going on. And at the same time, like a month before, my stepdad gave me a challenge. Like, hey, if you can juggle to 500, I'll give you $50. Mm. And, you know, stubborn as I am and I wanted money, I went for it. And when I, you know, juggled to 500, I realized that maybe these tricks aren't so difficult, mm-hmm. you know, because now I have the juggling down.
Right.
Went out, failed miserably. You know, it was winter. It was like this much snow in the driveway. But we, you know, kept on doing it. And I just fell in love with the sport immediately. But I sucked in the beginning.
And you've been sticking with it since then. Now you're at a certain level where obviously you're recognized, right?
Yeah.
You consider yourself a world-class freestyler?
I would say so, yeah.
Yeah, for sure, right?
Hopefully.
For sure.
Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, you compete at a world-class level.
All right,
yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
All right, what about you, Vlo?
I started 9 years ago. Mm. Like most kids, I was really into football. Mm-hmm.
And most European kids, because in America everyone's like, what are you talking about, man? I play basketball,
like,
bro.
Lacrosse, man.
Yeah, I play tennis or
basketball.
No, but
basketball. They had the Swedish championships in freestyle.
Okay.
The first time in 2008.
Yeah.
2008, yeah. And I went there and I saw these guys. And I was one of those kids that got stuck direct. Mm-hmm. Like
Right away. Okay.
And since that day, I'd just been training very hard. Mm-hmm. And after a few years, I quit soccer.
Mm-hmm. Hey.
Because you weren't even that good anyways, right? So it wasn't like that much of a sacrifice, right?
Nah, but I played quite serious, yeah.
You played in Ois, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I played until I was 14 or 15,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What position?
What do you think?
Goalkeeper.
For
water boy.
Come on.
Water boy.
No, were you four?
Yeah, of course I was.
Oh, okay, of course. All right,
so was I. I don't know. Honestly.
Okay, obviously. Strikers? Okay.
Yep.
And they gave it up, took on freestyle.
I so gave
how
it
many
up, yeah.
How many years has it been now for you?
9 years.
Okay.
9 years. Yeah.
Okay. So you're trying to, like, get to. So, like, between the two of you guys are, you know, in the same country, freestylers, friends. Is there a little bit of competition between you two? How do you guys look at it? Mentor, mentee, rivals, you hate him? What's the situation?
I hate him.
You hate him?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a love-hate story. Yeah? It's like, it changes every day. Right. Mm-hmm. I can wake up and like, ah, screw this guy.
Yeah. Right. Douchebag.
But I mean, the community in Sweden is so like
it's
so
small.
Tight.
Yeah, it's very
no,
tight.
No, it's bigger.
It's, big?
It's bigger than this the U.S. Okay. community. Yeah.
So like, when you say community, you're talking about
all freestylers
yeah. within yeah. Sweden.
Yeah. So like okay. 400.
Okay. Okay. Well, that's big because I only yeah. know like five.
Yeah.
Well, two out of the five. You know?
There's a lot of freestylers okay. and there's not a lot of jobs. So that's
what I'm talking about. So
that's
you know what I mean?
Could cause rivalry, but okay. there is none. Like I've invited VLO to do jobs with me. Mm. I've even given away jobs to him right. and to other people. So, okay. Because since we're friends first and business competitors second, we will just
it works
you know,
out.
Yeah, it works out.
Gotcha. Gotcha. Okay. And then you also mentioned how you guys are not too far from Denmark, so you guys know the Copenhagen Pana House
yep.
community, right? And you guys are cool with them. Okay. So then what are your guys' thoughts on, because you guys are hardcore freestylers, professionals, what do you guys think of the whole street soccer scene then?
Oh, I respect it so much. Mm-hmm. Like, I've been hanging out with Pana House a lot since it's only like 10 minutes from the office, mm-hmm. and it's only like 25 minutes from my house. So it's really easy for me to get there, and even the Danish freestyle community has, you know, open trainings in a place called Street Mecca, okay. where also the Pana House trains,
yeah.
and sometimes they train during the same day. So you meet up with the whole Pana community, you meet up with the whole freestyle community all at once, and yeah. then you like learn, you teach, okay. and like you meet up with the best, because in my opinion, the Danish community in Pana and street soccer are, you know, without a doubt, the best
there.
In the world.
Okay,
so you learn a lot.
All right, let's just jump to something else, all right? Because, like, you guys are young guys, and you guys are 2 weeks in America, in L.A. area. Like, what have you guys been doing for 2 weeks? You've been partying? Let's start with VLO. You made some girls here? What? Okay, well, what's your situation, the girlfriend situation, first of all?
I got a girlfriend, yeah.
You do? Back
yeah.
home?
Yeah, back home.
You still
home.
Do?
Yeah.
After 2 weeks here?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, great.
Nah, but I'm just 20, so it's hard to party here when you're 20.
Oh, okay. You're
in 20, Sweden, you can
right.
party when you're...
Right.
18.
It's okay. We know some spots. We'll take you in a little bit.
Come on, man.
So you have a girlfriend back home, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And you have a girlfriend as well.
Of course. Yeah, you know that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't
You've
know.
Seen the videos.
I have seen the videos, but it's been a while, so I don't know if you guys are still together or not.
It was
so,
Valentine's Day. That, okay. That's like, what, 1.5 months ago?
Right, right. Yeah. Okay. So you guys both fully committed boyfriends and not partying with random girls in L.A. at all.
Does Caitlin count as a random girl?
No, not at all. Caitlin's a friend, right? Yeah. Right.
Just
so outside of Caitlin, so yeah, you guys have been good boyfriends, basically,
yeah.
right? Yeah.
We're good boyfriends.
But you
yeah,
guys have,
yeah.
Okay, so you guys have had fun in LA while you've been here, though? What have you guys done so far?
Training.
Just stick to the legal stuff, all right?
Yeah. Training.
Training. Come on. Yeah. 2 weeks, LA. What are some of the fun places you guys have been to?
I like Venice.
You did
yeah.
like Venice, huh?
We've been to Venice a lot.
Yeah, because Kevin, the guy who's
yeah.
staying
Kevin
at.
Kevin Medina, we know.
Yeah, yeah. yeah. We're staying at his house, and he works in Venice. So obviously, since we don't have a
right.
you know a car, we just ride with him to Venice, and we just okay. hang out there.
Hang out. What you guys? Because we know Venice. So like, what you guys been doing in Venice?
Training.
Are you sure you guys were training in Venice?
It's been a lot of training.
A lot of training. Or training.
Training.
Okay. All right. Where? Like on the beach or what? Like where?
Yeah, on the beach. Yeah.
On the beach.
Basketball court.
Were you guys busking at all while you were there?
No.
No.
You
no
need
license.
Permission. To
oh, no license. Oh, yeah. You guys are all it's by the book, huh?
Mm-hmm. You know it.
Okay. That's good.
No, but 2 days ago we had a big freestyle meet.
Yeah.
At Venice. Mm. I think there were like 8 guys.
Yeah, 8 or 9 guys. Yeah.
Yeah.
All showed up, and so
all
that's like
up,
kind
yeah.
of the freestyle community aspect that you guys really like,
mm-hmm. yeah.
where you can go to pretty much like any country.
Just meet up with people.
Yeah.
You just train
people.
And jam together. That's
okay.
the best.
That's the best
right.
thing, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. You know what's interesting, though, is, like, freestylers, they're so, like, they're like, the modern-day, you know, a bohemian, you know, art, you know, like, artists that just, you know, they're, like, anti-establishment in the sense of, like, they don't worry too much about certain things that most people worry about. You know what I mean?
Like they're what,
very rent. Rent. Exactly. Rent, car payment. You know, like they just, you know what I mean? Like they follow their passion, right? Yeah. Which is different from a lot of people, right? For sure. But at the same time, it's like they're not as like crazy party animals as I thought they would. Because like when I meet with freestylers, really? I don't know. Because well, like every time I meet with freestylers, like I thought they just, because of the fact that they're not trying to get a traditional job, trying to do the traditional lifestyle, that they'd be like way out there, right? But they're not.
But like the same, the we're part artists, part athletes.
Okay.
So
we that's the funky dynamic, right?
Yeah.
So how do you balance that then?
Well, you can't really.
Okay.
Well, you just have to make sacrifices in one part and then, you know, compromise that with the other part. So, obviously, every big freestyle meeting or big competition, there's a huge after party, and there's always 100 stories from every after party ever.
Okay. So basically, you guys are saying like for the as athletes for the event, you try to stay as disciplined as possible, and then once it's done, then it's just free then for all kind of.
Yeah.
Right? Then you don't want to be there,
or I don't know what.
You don't want to be there.
I don't want to be there.
If you're not a freestyler,
it's crazy. You wouldn't understand.
I don't think so. No.
Okay. Okay, so that kind of makes sense then. Okay, so then what have you guys enjoyed so far outside of Venice? Have you guys been to, you know, other parts in LA? Yeah. I know you guys were like hanging out with Alex, right?
Yeah, we're
in,
hanging like, out
East
with
LA.
Alex.
East LA, yeah.
Yeah, he took you guys to like gang territory. You guys didn't even know, huh? Like,
no, we were sitting on a curb eating tacos.
Street tacos. Sitting on a curb eating tacos. Like drive-bys happening behind you. You
guys don't 2 a.m. just.
Right. 2 a.m. Right.
Chilling, bro.
Chilling.
Yeah, just.
That was some good taco though.
That was some. Damn good tacos.
That was the best taco so far.
But with pastor, dude, that's that stuff is
spicy.
Okay.
It was good.
Mm-hmm.
But so, we went to a place outside Barstow, which is the most random place ever.
Right.
So I saw this skate video of a dude named Killian Martin, and he made a video in an abandoned water park outside Barstow. So which is like what, 2.5 hours from Long Beach? Mm-hmm. And so we drove there, made a video there, and drove back. Just a day trip. That was pretty cool.
So it feels like you guys are just like really very free-flowing. First of all, you guys are here on vacation, obviously. So 2 weeks, just had a great time meeting friends, introducing yourself to new people, checking out different sites. But like on a day-to-day basis, it sounds like you guys are very kind of go with the flow, right? Yeah. What business opportunities come, you take it, like, you know?
Of course basically, we wake up every day with one thing on our agenda, and that is a train. And everything else...
You insert it in between whatever happens, kind of?
Exactly.
Okay. So then, like, same thing? Like, when you say you wake up to train, like, what time are we talking about? I want to figure out this bohemian lifestyle. Like, 8 a.m., very disciplined, or, are you like, you know, 2 p.m. after partying all night long?
It's still vacation, man.
Yeah. It's still vacation. The earliest training we had was, like, 12, I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
But usually at home, there's different, you know, disciplines. But
Yeah. That was what was in our mind when we got it. Like we have to train.
Yeah, we haven't trained outdoors.
Okay.
It is a vacation, but we have to train. If we don't train in 2 weeks,
we're screwed.
Yeah, your body.
You drop
that.
So much.
Okay. So where you guys headed out to next then? And you know, what do you guys? You going back home or what?
Yeah, we're leaving tomorrow. Coming back home, and then we're staying like a week at home.
Yeah, and then we're going to Poland.
Yeah.
And what's in Poland?
In Poland, there's international competition called Focus on Freestyle, which is a very high level competition with like the 12 best freestylers from Poland, I think, and 4 people that are invited.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then these type of events that you guys go on, is that how you guys make your living? You know what I'm saying? And like, I know Unisport, right? They help you. So how does that work with like Unisport? What's the relationship between you and Unisport?
Well, basically I can go to work and we make tutorials, we make boot reviews, play tests, and we talk about like football products. Mm. And that is, you know, a part of my job. Sometimes I even do like freestyle tricks, film them, send it to them, and they post it on Instagram.
So you have like an annual, are you like an employee and you just have like a monthly paycheck? Is it like a normal paycheck or is it based on like a video?
It's a very, very, very complicated thing that is too much to explain. But I have a job that, you know, gets me going every month to pay rent. So I don't have to worry about that part too much.
Right. So from like a day-to-day perspective, your job pays for your lifestyle and you're still trying to grow that and do different opportunities while being able to compete and train.
Because it's not that time consuming to go to work at Unisport.
It's like pretty close by where you live?
And I don't have to go every day.
Okay.
So I can go once a week, twice a month, once a month, as long as I do, you know, the things that are required for me to do.
Right. That's like an ideal job for like a freestyle, it sounds like.
It's perfect.
Yeah. Okay, awesome. Shout out to Unisport. We love it. We like what's
Tack the... Jakob for
Felt. It's like continue, yeah, the relationship, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
All right, what about you, VLO? So then, obviously, you're a freestyler that's continuing to grow and you want to be a professional and use that as a living, right? What are some of the things, the opportunities that you're hoping for? You know, what do you look for in the future?
My main goal is to be one of the top freestylers.
Okay.
That's my main goal.
Oh, you're there, bro.
Yeah.
I want to get further.
All right.
Okay.
Besides that, it's the marketing, it's the shows, the performance.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a lot more recently.
Okay.
The last 2 years.
How does a company find you? You know, because I know and I'm in freestyle, so I look, but like if I'm like this company and I just need a good looking blonde Sweden freestyler, how are they going to find you, first of all? You know what I mean?
It's hard.
That's it, the hard part, right? Yeah.
There should be a hashtag blonde Swedish good looking freestyler.
But there isn't.
Slash Mr. Maybe.
Yeah. Hashtag VLO, right? Okay.
Nah, but you got to make a name of yourself, I guess. And until then, try to market yourself as good as possible on social medias. But it's hard. It's very hard.
Yeah, it's really hard. It took me a lot of years to you know, grow the audience that I have, and get the shows that I get on a continuous basis.
Yeah,
it's really difficult. But
that's also one thing. Once you get a show and you do well, most likely they want you next year as well.
Right. Yeah, and possibly there's someone in the audience who wants you for another show.
Okay, exactly.
So it's like ripple effect. Is that correct?
Ripple effect. Yeah.
So one show can give you more shows. So if you're starting off and you want to get paid, it's very difficult to say, hey, I want this much money for my first show ever.
Okay.
So in the beginning, it's like better to have a low fee or even nothing at all.
Yeah, do it
just to get, you know,
just to get
the
your
networking.
Foot in the door.
Exactly.
Okay. Okay.
To get
comfortable. So you guys have managers? Management, how does that work?
I don't really have a manager, but there is people out there who help you get jobs.
Okay.
But not like a manager.
Okay. What about you?
I've had one, worked out for a little bit. And then again, same stuff there, that I have people helping me out. Like, this is my person in this area, could help me out doing shows, you know, in this part of the world. So
got it.
Kind of works out. And there's nothing on contract, so we good. Right.
So different territories and different areas.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, because you recently competed in the Asian, right?
Yeah.
The AF, the Asian, what was it?
Asian Freestyle Football Competition.
Football competition, right? And you represented Philippines.
Yep.
Okay. And within that network, and did they accept you? Because, you know, like most people, they don't know that you have that background, right? They freak out. They're like, dude, who's this random guy from Sweden trying to compete in the Asian freestyle competition here, right? And trying to take the trophy.
Exactly. Well, the thing is that...
douchebag.
Douchebag. Representing Philippines.
the thing is that I have this charity project in the Philippines where I help... children develop street football skills and freestyle skills.
Okay.
If they don't have enough money for, you know, equipment for a halt play and or whatever. So I do that, and I go to Manila and I have these workshops and give clothings and stuff like that. So that's kind of how the community in the Philippines started.
Okay.
So before I was there, there was one freestyler in the Philippines.
Okay. Who's that?
Abdurrahman Mabayaya from Davao.
Okay.
And he was the only guy freestyling in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
So when I went to Manila and kind of inspired people to start, we kind of grew this small community in just a small part of Manila.
Mm-hmm.
And they grew, you know, their own freestyle community. I've been, you know, accepted by them, so you know, I'm not the.
They didn't mind this random white dude Sweden representing them. Is what you're trying to say, right?
Well,
they didn't mind.
Half white dude.
Half white dude, right? But like, you
he's
know,
white.
Online, yeah, he's white. Like online, and you present yourself, and you live in Sweden, right?
Take a line.
So they didn't mind, right?
It's gone.
So they're like, okay, we accept him, and it was kosher. You're saying, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay,
so
you didn't just great. So
I didn't intrude.
Yeah, you didn't just randomly show up at the day of the competition and be like, yo, my dad is Filipino.
No,
I'm just gonna enter. It wasn't like that.
No.
Okay.
I made a choice 2013 for the first world tour.
Okay.
Which country to represent, and I chose the Philippines because I think that we could, like, together grow the community there, and I do have a strong connection to the country, even though I was not born or raised in the country. And I do think that I have a lot to give, especially to that community called Tondo. And that's the place in the Philippines where I feel at home, even though I feel threatened there.
You do?
It's a really rough area.
It is, right? Yeah. Philippines is not like...
It's not East LA, my friend. It's worse.
It's worse, okay.
Yeah.
But you like the food there while you were there?
I love the food.
Adobo chicken or what?
No, I'm all about seasick. Okay. Every day.
Okay. All right, great. All right, so then now, you know, you guys have a day left, you know. You have any kind of last words for your fans or expectations that you guys are having? You know, last words before we sign off here? What do you think?
Mr. Vlo.
Come on, dude. Vlo. Last words.
Yeah. Okay, let's to the female LA fans that are still around.
Caitlin, yeah. Thank you for the support. uh-huh. Really appreciate it.
Okay.
No, but I mean, if there's anyone out there who's want to pursue freestyle, it may look difficult, but step by step, it is the journey is so much fun. Mm-hmm. Even when I started, it was frustrating, but fun. Like every new trick you learned was like the best feeling in the world. So in the beginning, it's just like a cluster of euphoric mm-hmm. feelings mm-hmm. when you land a new trick. Mm-hmm. So catch that feeling and you're hooked forever. Gotcha. I promise.
Gotcha. Sounds like a drug. All right, what about you, Vlo?
It is.
Yeah. It's compared to play football, like scoring a goal. Mm. Landing a new trick is like scoring a goal.
Okay.
But even better.
Right. Even better, yo.
Even better, yo. Dude.
All right, great. Yeah. All right. So hopefully you guys have a great time the rest of your trip here.
Thank you.
Wish you
Thank
the best you. Of luck online and in your travels. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you guys for joining us on the Urban Pitch Podcast, Beautiful Game of Life.